Let's now do a short demo of both comparison and logical operators. Among comparison operators, we are going to test equality and not equality of object references. That is, we are going to test both equal to and not equal to operators. And rest of them, like greater than, less than, and other variants, are straightforward, and let's not worry about them for now. Okay, you can just try it out yourself. Next, after that, we will generate a null pointer exception. Finally, we will try to avoid it by using logical AND operator. We already discussed it in the logical operators lesson. And we will also test logical OR. And for this demo, we will use the student example code that we wrote earlier in the last chapter. And it basically has two classes, student and student test. And from the student test class, we create student objects. And we are going to write our code in the student test class. Okay, so let's just go ahead and do that. So here we are in the student test class. And we have these three student objects here, student 1, student 2, and student 3. And they are initialized with these values, ID and name. So there are three students. So let's just go ahead, and each of them are referencing three different objects, right? Student objects. So let's just put an if statement here. Student 1, let's just test equal to operator now, equals student 2. Let's just put a print statement. So let's just say student 1 and student 2 are referencing different objects. So, sorry, are referencing same objects. So, which is not true. So, this particular condition should fail. And that body should not get executed, body of the if condition here. So let's also put not equals, and in this case are referencing different objects. Okay, so let's just go ahead and compile and run this. Student test has been compiled, and let's just run this. So as you can see, it says here student 1 and student 2 are referencing different objects, which is true, right? Because they are just referencing two different objects. So this not equals to condition will pass, and then this statement is getting executed. Now let's just go ahead and create a new student object, student 4, and let's initialize it to null, and let's put print statement here. And let's just say student 4 name. So name is a variable in the student class here. So we are just printing the name here, and this would generate an error at runtime because we are accessing a method on a null reference. Here it is, it says null pointer exception at line 36. Okay, so here it is at line 36. So let's just put, so we know that we can avoid this by doing a null check. So we'll say student 4 not equals null, only then we want to print this. So you don't have the null pointer exception anymore. So we are checking it by comparing it with, by doing a null check here. Okay. And now let's assign student 4. Instead of creating a new student object, let's just assign student one here. Now it's going to print the student name, the new student name, which is John. As you can see here, it prints John. Here it is, prints John, because now both student 4 and student 1, student 1's name is John here. If you see here, it's John, it's Joanne, but we are actually updating it here to John, to the right name. So both John, both student 1 and student 4 are pointing to the same object, and the name of the student is John. Now we can also have an AND condition here, and let's say we want to do this check only if both student 4 and student 1 are, you know, are pointing to the same student object. So we can just have, so this is a logical and we can just say student 4 equals student 1. Only then we want to print the student's name. Okay. And there you go. It's still printing John's name because both of them are referencing the same student object. Now let's put one more condition here. Let's say if student is not equal to null and student is equal to 2, student 2, or student 4 equals to student 1. So which means, so it has to be null, and on top of that we also want to get execute this particular statement only if student 4 is referencing either the same object as student 2 or the same object as student 1. Only then we are going to print the name. So in this case, let's just, the student's name would be printed twice, as you can see here, because it got printed here in the first if condition. Then in the second if condition, student 4 not equals null is true, and then over here, so this is true, and over here this is false, but then this is true. So false or true is basically true. So, and then it's going to print the student 4's name once again for the second time. Okay, so this is the logical OR. So that's about it. So that's a short demo of both comparison operators and logical operators, logical and logical OR. Okay. All right then. Thank you.